It's 4 FSI. I just thought let's do a little graphic presentation. The middle one is not a platform. That is how we are supposed to live in this metro corridor. In Pune, these are the various densities that are present in different parts. So if you are 0 to 50 people, one person lives, it's exactly to scale. The number of figures of people are to scale. So then you get a visual. Okay. See this portion, the red, this is the proposed density, 5000 people per hectare. This density is 200 to 250 people per hectare. This is the density in Delhi metro area, incidentally. I was just taking the Delhi routes. I thought let's get to Delhi and find out what Delhi has done. They have no 4 FSI, no densification, nothing. This is their average density all along the metro. If our density is 1000 to 1050, which is the density in some parts of the city, this is how many people are there. If it is 100 to 150, this is how many people are there. 650 to 700, this is how it will look.
Jhopadpatti.
This, yeah, these two can be the Jhopadpatti, but this is where they want to put all of this.
I am quite confused because you are saying that there is in the corridor, there won't be any shops and all, they will be demolished.
Then
and at the same time, you are saying that the population density will grow how?
10 meters from both sides of the metro. There will be no development.
Okay. And beyond that,
there are 500 meters on both sides, which is where they are proposing this, with 4 FSI. So they want to increase it 4 times.
What is the height?
In FSI 1, they want to make a population density of 5000 people per hectare. So
how,
if it is
how can they increase the density? They want to have people to have more children.
No, they want people to come and migrate and settle there. Because they will travel
they
on the train.
I agree. As I see that the density will become 4 times what it is now because the FSI grows from 1 to 4.
No, unfortunately they want today's density there. Let's say in Ferguson College Road area where I live, it is 250 is the density, 250 to 75. Because all these grounds are there. You know, what we don't realize is there is a...
Where does that figure in your 250 density in the
Okay. Fine. This is all right. We have the water supply, we have the road, I mean, even the energy fields covered, all these things are there. Now they want to go here.
That's wishful thinking.
That's what, no. This is what they are proposing. The development control rules, where they have invited objections, suggestions, this is what the development control rules. I am just sharing what the development control rules are saying. Okay? Just 1 minute, be patient. The other thing they are saying is that the minimum plot size in the metro corridor will be 0.2 hectares. That means 20,000 square feet. Minimum plot size. Okay. Now, this area, all these areas where the metro is going, have already come under what is known as the town planning scheme. And that town planning scheme was implemented long back. So, when you implement a town planning scheme, to implement a development plan, what you do is you do land pooling and you do land redistribution. So, when you pool the land, you take away almost 40% of the land from every plot owner. For roads, for amenities, for facilities, for playground, for park, for everything. The norm is, this is how much you need. So 40% of the land is taken away and then you are given what is known as a reconstituted plot. A developed, reconstituted plot on which you can build. So we have, those of us who live in that area, the owners have already given 40% of the land to make the roads, to make the playgrounds, parks, schools, all the amenities. It's already done. So the area of the plot is 40% less already. It's called final plot. I'm sure those of you who live in these town planning areas know that you have a survey number, a city survey number, CTS number, and you have what is known as the FP, final plot. So the final plot means the town planning scheme has been implemented. Point number two is, we were under the urban land ceilings till 2 years back. Pune was under urban land ceiling. What was the ceiling? That the maximum land, the plot size that we can have is 1000 square meters.
Yes. No, 10,000 square feet.
11,000 square
feet. Yeah, yeah.
To be exact. Okay. So, how can we, the minimum plot size be 0.2 hectares? 21,000 and odd square feet. That means all these plots, the plot owners have to do amalgamations. If you have a 0.2 hectare plot, then you can avail of 4 hectares. Otherwise, but that's okay. People will say, fine, you don't want 4 FSI, you don't want to do anything in Abhi where we are living. No, 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 you are not allowed to do that. What they will do is they will charge us a CIS. They will bhurdanda ganate apne.
If you don't develop it.
If you don't develop it, they are going to tax us for that. So they are saying they will demolish everything. 10 meters either side of the metro, 2 sides, 500 meters corridor, 1 kilometer, FSR 4, density 5000 per hectare, minimum plot size 2.2 hectares. Yes.
What will they do if there are any heritage property sites?
Our experience is that they don't care. They think, hey, sagli maya ahe, apan sagla kshanam hamgu hai, jau de gelo. This is the corporation's viewpoint. If you ask me, this is their attitude towards heritage. They don't believe in heritage right now. You know, they are not even public, not mean, Sujit has been working on the, he was a member of the heritage.
No, no, just a basic fact. I don't take too much time because his presentation is next. Matakaleshwar temple, Shalimar Mada, and Adaras Palace are the only 3 national level heritage monuments in Pune. Only 3. All others are grade 1, grade 2 done by the corporation. But national level, certified by the Archaeological Society of India, there are only 3. Now the rules of the archaeological survey says that within 100 meters around the heritage sites, you cannot have any construction. Since the rules came, maybe something has been consulted. So Matakaleshwar has got that post office behind. That was done earlier. But now if you put a proposal, it will be refused. Up to 100 meters. In spite of all this, they are building a great separator, which is a road to solve the traffic problems in the wrong way according to us. And they, when they started, we went to court, High Court. And High Court said it's a public interest work, so they give the judgment in favor of the corporation. That means within 100 meters, in spite of the rules, the national rules saying that 100 meters is not allowed. So that shows you how much they care for the heritage. Lesser heritage is like the engineering college, they are also building double flyover. And they have just gone ahead and decided to do it. Forget anything else. And heritage committee was bulldozed to give them the okay. Because they gave it recently. Construction started a couple of years back. So that is the reality of the...
If this is the rule, how can the High Court go against it?
How? I don't know. We are it's not easy to go to Supreme Court.
Get the court even to stop all this nonsense.
No, what is the point?
This is just a, you know, a large picture.
No, corporation said it's not a concern to look at me underneath. So, I mean, the corporation
is
not
a high court plump.
See, I think that heart is not in the right place, yeah, as far as the heritage is concerned. So, they really don't care what happens to the heritage. This is the corridor, 500 meters. See, this red line is the metro, and on the side, if you see this, the small pink area, this is that 10 meter thing from where all the shops and everything will be removed. And this is the, this is the 500 meter, this is 1 kilometer.
Either side.
This is, I did a little calculation, how much area goes under the metro. It is something like, this is the area, this any Aadmi metro influence is 32.95 square kilometers or 3295 hectares. With 4 acres, it becomes 13,180 hectares or 131.80 square kilometers to be added to the old city. They are almost planning to double the area of the
city. Old city is 147 square kilometers.
147, yeah. So this is almost 70. It's just a little short of that. Okay, this is from, this is quoted from the development plan. This is section 14.3.2. So we have to copy it. Development plan. 14.3.2 madhyaye. Transport systems such as metro and BRT have been proposed along major routes. It is suggested to densify the area of 500 meters along both sides of the metro with the expected gross residential density of 5,000 persons per hectare for the public transport to be efficient and effective. Then don't do it. It's not necessary, obviously. They can't justify it. Okay, so this is what they wish to. Now, with a proposed gross population density of 5,000 per hectare, this will accommodate a population of 65.90 million people, which is the total population of France. Just to give a comparison. They are not thinking, obviously. So what does it mean in real terms? A gross density of 5,000, this is well below even the Zopatpatti norm, which I just explained to you. I was thinking that if it is 4 FSI, they will get 8 square meters. And they will know, but it's gross density per hectare. So for every hectare, whether it is up or down, it is 5,000. So we don't go over that. Okay. Now this elevated metro is proposed to run on Jangli Maharaj. But this means Upte Road comes in the 500 meter zone. And the airport, average value right now in that Deccan area, 15,000 rupees a square foot. So, you know, for 10 square meters, who will pay 15 lakhs? I mean, I don't know what they are thinking. The entire land market will collapse. I mean, this is also not economically viable. Forget who, anything else.
Who gains from this all so far?
We have to figure out. Clearly, the whole proposal is economically as well as culturally and socially untenable. Because it's it, I don't think it's going to
work. Would we not consider an alternative route?
Oh, sorry, yeah. Okay. Karayalas by the way. Hey, okay, it comes a Kothrur. Kothrur, I had gone there, they had invited me to explain this to them. So they are now fighting them at the court. And they will get in. Because they said we are very happy, they are all final plot holders, they are small bungalows. These are a lot of teachers and people like that who have built their houses there and they have zero interest. They thought they were all going to get 4 FSI. You know, so they could build on top 4 FSI and then that's an income also. So it might have made sense. But now they realize that if they want to get 4 FSI, they have to amalgamate at least 4 blocks. So 4 people coming together and doing amalgamation is not going to work. A lot of builders are going around that area and offering them that anyway, they are saying, anyway your house is going to fall, they demolish Karnare, so why don't you want it to be now? Because of that 10 meter thing. See, in the original proposal, this 10 meter thing was not there, was it? I think this some smart builder has proposed.
Yeah, initially
it was not there.
It's only 500 meters.
Yes, but now they have this 10 meter, actually, no development.
It's hardly saying 10 meters are only very structured.
It's there. When you added it, it's their notification. That's how we found out.
It's effective since when? For when to be effective?
It is not. It will go for hearing now. No? They increase the date.
So, builder offering the rates at that rate, he's sure it's going to happen.
Builder are always sure that whatever they have paid off is going to bring them the benefits. Let's see how, I mean, what we are able to
do. Yes. We have to grant rights. Collect enough rights. Collect enough rights.
That's the main thing. So the metro is between Ramwadi to...
This is Ramwadi, that's near Kalyani now.
See, this river bank is available along here. And most of the river bank is dry, except for a week in a year.
Okay.
So why can't the elevated railway be made along the main circuit? No demolishing of
control.
But
why do you want an elevated metro?
I mean, that's how it is in Delhi, no?
See,
the whole thing in Delhi.
It's a 19th century option.
Yeah.
Let's go forward, I think. Let's not use a 19th century option. I mean, I have got some noise for you. Would you like to hear the sound?
No, as the Delhi Metro is.
No, no, Delhi Metro is also not elevated. Delhi Metro, actually, somebody, I just read a study carried out by various engineering college students, published in some other places which I am just reading. They are saying that the decibels which are tolerable, I mean, before it becomes really polluted, has can have health impact. I think 55 is.
55 industrial, 45 the residential.
Yes, for it. But they are saying along the metro route, let's say that 55. Okay? Industrial residential.
Everywhere you want to go against national law.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, but the thing is, like, what is happening is, these guys have done some 6-7 stations, and nowhere is it less than 75 to 80. Decibels along the entire route of the metro, the elevated metro, it's like I have got the noise of the
people. I haven't understood the objection on having metro along the
river.
Yes.
Anybody else would like to
take this? This answers the problem of the
actually, we would like the river to be a river.
No, banks of the river. I'm not saying
banks of the river are also part of the river. No?
But most of the time it's dry. People are
but that's part of the river ecology.
It is much better alternative than
no, why?
Long
no,
river.
No,
I don't
the road and the roads along the river bed. We can't have the metro.
See, these corridors are already dense. Why are we making them?
Exactly.
What is the logic?
Why are you going underground now? If you are so keen on having a metro, go underground.
No, no, but why choose metro as a mode of transport?
I'm not saying it.
No, no, what I'm saying is, see, and some of these things, what they are saying, we have to be careful because they will drop it. And they will say that, okay, we'll drop this, you know, Hector rule and everything, and will you support the metro? So that, I think those rules are absolutely, I think they are there to divert the attention, in my opinion.
Absolutely.
The critical thing is this a right move, given the density of the city? Which, that's what I think the discussion
should
be
done. Wait, then, okay, just to speak in favor of the metro.
Yeah.
Generally, a metro is proposed when the population goes over 2.5 million. But our population is more than 3.5 million. So, the total population of Pune, you can justify a metro. But it does not need any densification. A metro comes into the picture, like normally when I teach my students, I will say that, okay, let's look at Bajirao Road, for example. Bajirao Road is one way, and from Tirak Road to Lakshmi Road, right? The length of Bajirao Road is about 2.2 kilometers. And if you have buses on it, then we have done some traffic volume counts and studies and everything. We found that given the traffic, if you want to put all those people into a bus, you will have to have a bus every 2 minutes, you know, going.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, when you have a bus every 2 minutes and the stops are, I think, one furlong in the old days, so it's like 200 meters. So, if you have a stop at 200 meters, you are going to stop your bus, brake, let passengers out, let passengers in, and then accelerate, and then your stop is there. So, when that happens, it really actually becomes like a train.
Yeah.
It's so close together. That's when you propose a trail.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
Any kind of
it.
Yeah. BRT. BRT also, it's a bus.
Yeah.
So you can have a tram or you can have a train.
Yeah.
The train should go underground because then you are exploiting. What are they saying? Why elevated? Because they are saying, okay, we are taking addition and we are creating space
yeah.
in the sky. Better create it underground. You know, I mean, genuinely, it will
yeah.
be just for the people. If it is underground, I mean the positives, if it's underground, Pune has not gone very high yet. So one of our old friends, Mr. P.G. Patankar, who was very pro-metro, he used to work for the railways, he was also the best in Bombay. He used to say that, you know, now if we dig 30 meters, it's enough because there are no skyscrapers in Pune. So you don't have to worry about that. So it's cheaper to dig just now. The other thing is there is no land acquisition, I mean hardly any land acquisition. Except for where the stations you have to punch. You have this all this modern technology which tunnels and cements and everything, right? The thing is, you are saying you can also go as the crow flies underground. So the distances are also not, it's not like you're going along the road. If you build an elevated metro, the only place where they can build is they are going to go along the road. But they are cutting off the Deccan Gymkhana post office, Chittagong, Bandu, Deccan, that half the area of Deccan Gymkhana is gone. The ground, the playground, those houses there, everything, that is the way, because it cannot turn otherwise. So yes, if Pune Municipal Corporation is dead keen on having a metro, then let's have an underground.
What is the argument against that?
They're saying it's expensive, but then they do the expensive thing. That is the proper thing for Pune. Because no metro is amortized over 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Typically amortized over a period of 100 years.
What difference?
200 crores per kilometer.
Amortized over 100 years. 100 years, it will not work on the standard base. Because the capacity saturation comes in 25 years.
Okay.
Then you have to build another land.
25 years.
So, 25 years.
But you will recover.
Your ticket price goes up.
You will recover if it is so much crowding. You will recover the value. For me, the tram is the best option for a city like you. We have done a study of a tram, and we can present it to you.
No, instead of rain, tram service. Go for trolley buses. The same thing.
Buses are
main. Trolley buses.
Trolley buses. If tram is better.
This is the
corridor, the 10 meter thing, which we want to, we want to show you what it will look like. So this is the metro at Banas, and I'm in the street. I would like you to hear some.
Noise.
So I think that is very important. Can somebody help?